Students, so this week we are discussing about part 4 video, Is Matter Around Us Pure? So the last part of this lesson, first topic is physical and chemical changes. So what do you mean by physical change and chemical change? So this is understand by discussing about first one, physical changes. Physical means the body of the content or body of the matter, body of the substance undergo change into another one physical body of matter or substance or compound, etc., etc. So the change in which only transformations of state is happened. So this is called a physical change. Physical change means the change in which only transformations of state is happening. So no new substance is formed or made up of your suitable technique. So this is called a physical change. So physical change is a reversible process. For example, the one of the best example, so melting of ice. Ice is placed in heat place, means it is undergoes melting and converted into liquid paste. So ice is a solid paste, so it is converted into liquid paste of water. So both water and ice containing the chemical formula is H2O, water molecular formula. So composition, chemical composition do not change. This method of physical change. So physical change means only transformations of physical state. Physical state means solid, liquid, gas. So one state change into another. Solid converted into liquid, liquid converted into vapor, vapor converted into liquid, etc., etc. So all substance of matter undergoes this like changes, but a new substance here not formed. So this is called physical changes. So physical changes means the best example, melting of ice or breaching of water, etc., etc. So water boiling, so these all are physical change but do not change chemical composition. So this is called physical change. So nowadays we are discussing about many variety of process handled in our home is physical changes. So next we are discussing about chemical changes. Chemical changes means nothing about, so directly opposite for physical changes. Here new substance is formed and chemical compositions also change. Next, third one is it is irreversible process. So this is called chemical changes. So definition is the change in which a new substance, change in which a new substance is made. In the change, the chemical property of the substance is also changed. Substance means matter, particle, element, compound, etc., etc. So if any content or chemical substance consider as a normally substance in the change, so this is changed into their chemical composition and their property also. So these changes are irreversible. For example, cooking of food, for example boiling of egg, once egg boiled egg do not return for fluid form. So yeah, egg boiled means it is converted into jelly nature, into solid nature. So this is one of the best chemical change. Then rusting of iron. Iron undergoes oxidation, means it is converted into rust. Rust of iron matter. So this like process also called chemical changes. So chemical changes means nothing about the changes in the chemical property of matter. So we get a new substance. We get a new substance that is called chemical change. So chemical change means that is called chemical reaction during oxidation, reduction, hydration, dehydration, etc., etc. So these all chemical reactions also considered as a chemical change. So this is called physical and chemical change. So burning of candle. So this is undergoes both physical and chemical change takes place. Burning of candle means here candle is considered as a solid. It is converted into a liquid. This is called a chemical physical change process. Solid converted into liquid. It is a physical process, but burning is a chemical process. Burning of all matter change their character, but here candle only involved in burning, so it is called a chemical process. So all burning or pyrolysis process is called chemical changes. Pyrolysis, pyro means heat, lysis means separation or decomposition, etc., etc. So candle melted into liquid, it is a physical process, but it undergoes on heating process. This is called a chemical process. So this only we can easily distinguish. So next we are discussing about classifications of matter. So in this lesson startingly we are discuss about the matter. So matter can be classified into two types. One is pure substance and another one is called impure substance. This impure substance is considered as a mixer. So then these pure substances are furtherly classified into two types. One is element, next one is compound. This element means nothing but atom of particle is called element. So it is furtherly converted into three types: metal, non-metal, semi-metal, etc., etc. Metal means iron, gold, silver, platinum, zinc, sodium, potassium, etc., etc. It is called metal. Then next one type of element is non-metal. Non-metal means carbon, oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen, chlorine, sulfur, boron. These all are called non-metals. So semi-metal means silicon and germanium is best example for metal. These all are types of element. Then compound. Compound means the molecules combining of atom is called compound. So molecule, sugar, salt, this like also called compound. So next, second category of matter is pure substance or impure substance. Impure substance means mixer. So it is converted into pure form, but it is furtherly classified into two types. One is homogeneous mixer, next one is heterogeneous mixer. Homogeneous mixer means nothing but the mixture of two substances converted into single phase, that is called homo. Homo means same or single. So two or more different substances combine to form single phase of substance, that is called a mixer. It is present in pure or impure form. So pure form means, for example, making tea. So tea powder and milk, sugar, all are mixed together, but it is converted into only single liquid phase. This is called homogeneous. Then sugar dissolved in water. So water is a liquid base, sugar is a solid base, but two different base converted into any one of the base. So such type of mixer is called a homogeneous mix. Homogeneous mix. Then coolates, all coolates and beverage. Beverage of substance carbon dioxide, water converted into liquid form. It is also called homogeneous. Then next, heterogeneous mix. Heterogeneous means the mixture of substance exhibit in different place. Rocky road ice cream. So here water is a liquid, ice cream powder is a solid, but it is converted into a solid nature. So different base exhibited substance of mixture is called a heterogeneous mixture. Then muddy water. Muddy water means here exhibit in water liquid and muddy solid. So different base exhibited the mixture is called a heterogeneous. Single base exhibited mixture is called a homogeneous mixture. This is classifications of matter. So next we are discussing about what is element, what is compound, what is mixer. So these are distinguished between different substance takes place in different reagent bottle. So first we are listed in 8 type of substance. So these are classified into 3 category of matter. So A is 2 type of atom evenly mixed. What is this? Second one, 2 type of atom chemically combined. Third one, 1 type of atom. Fourth one, 2 type of atom mixed. Fifth one, an element. Sixth one, a solution. Seventh one, a combo. Eighth one, a mixer. So we are taking now 4 reagent bottle. So 2 of the descriptions to the right apply to each bottle below. Determine the appropriate description. First one is D and H. D means 2 type of atom are mixed. H means mixer. Here this type of atom only, yellow color atom. So 2 type of atom are mixed. So this is the first container. So these 2 type of atom are mixed. So here exhibit different phase also. So different content also. This is called a mixer. Then second bottle B and G. Second bottle B and G. B means 2 type of atom chemically combined. So this is A atom, this is B atom. Here AB molecule is formed, oxygen atom and hydrogen atom to form water, H2O. So this is B molecule, 2 type of atom chemically combined means that is called molecule. So hydrogen and oxygen combine to form water molecule. G means compound. So water is here one of the compound. So B and G is classified as a compound. B is a compound. A is a mixer. Mixer, this is compound. Then third bottle C and E combined. C means one type of element or one type of atom. E means that is called element. Only one type of atom is considered as a element. So hydrogen atom only placed in this kind of reagent bottle. So this is classified as a element. Third bottle is element. Then fourth, A and F combination. A and F combination. So A means two type of atom evenly mixed. F means this is called a solution. So here hydrogen air mixed with oxygen air. So two type of air molecule is combined. So this is called air solution. So first bottle is mixer, second bottle is a compound, third bottle contains the matter is element, fourth one is solutions or liquid phase. So this is the category of matter. So next we are discussing about type of matter. So now we are discussing about first one of the matter, pure substance. So pure substance means classified into three types. So that is discussed in previous chart: element, compound. So this is called types of pure substance. So pure substance mainly classified into two broad types. So the first one of the pure substance is element. Element is a basic form of matter, so which cannot broken down into simpler substance, because it is also one of the simpler substance. So it is cannot be furtherly divided into single substance by any one chemical reaction. So this is called element. So element are of three types. So they are called metal, non-metal, and metalloid. Metalloid or semi-metal, both are same. So we are already discussed the examples of three type of element: metal, non-metal, and semi-metal. Metal means conductivity property of matter, matter of element. Non-metal means insulating material of matter of element. Then metalloid is both character are equally have an indifferent situation. So this is called a three type of elements. So now we are discussing about this three type of element character. So first one is character of or property of metal. What is mean by metal? So metal means they are luster. So it is shiningly brightness or exhibited character is luster. They are malleable and ductile. So it is converted into sheet type or rod type and ductile. It is one metal converted into folded or converted into sheet type. This is called malleable and ductile nature. They are good conductor of heat and electricity. All metal conduct heat and electricity. So they are sonorous. Sonorous means make big sound. So all metal touch with one another means make sound by metal or any other content. So a good example is iron, aluminium, zinc, mercury, copper, silver, gold, etc., etc. So next, the property of non-metal. So non-metal means do not have luster. So it is one type of light shining nature. They are not malleable and ductility. So they are poor conductor of heat and electricity. So do not conduct electricity and heat passed through them. So they are not make sound. This is called sonorous. So it is not, non-metal is not make sound. So only metal only make sonorous. So example is hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, these all are gas, is non-element. Iodine, carbon, sulfur, phosphorus, this is also another type of non-metal. Then third one is properties of metalloid. Metalloid means so it have equal property of metal and non metal character. So it is exhibit in metal character at one time and exhibit the non metal character at another time. This is called metalloid or non or semi metal or semi metal. So metalloids are element which show the properties of metal and some properties of non metal. Example, boron, silicon and germanium. So silicon and germanium is best examples of non metal. So next one topic, the second type of element is compound. Second type of element is compound. Compound is a mixture of substance, so the substance composed of two or more element chemically combined together in a fixed ratio or any proportional ratio. So example, water. Water means, so H2O, here H2 is 2 ratio, oxygen is 1 ratio, so 2 is to 1 ratio. Then carbon dioxide, carbon CO2, carbon is 1 mole, oxygen is 2 mole, 1 is to 2 ratio. Then sugar, sugar means carbohydrate, glucose C6H12O6, carbon 6 mole, oxygen 6 mole, hydrogen 12 mole. Then salt, NaCl, so it is 1 is to 1 ratio. Then sulfide, iron sulfide, ferrous sulfide or ferric sulfide, FeS, Fe2S3, so this is called iron sulfide. So this is 1 is to 1 ratio. These all are different type of compound. So next we are discussing about the difference between mixture and compound. So mixture and compound difference is very must for understanding easily both of them. First one is mixture. So mixer is also called a two or more element or compound mixed together, but in impure form. But compound is a same two or more element chemically combined. Here two or more element or compound mixed together, but compound means two or more element chemically combined together to make new molecule at pure form. Then next, the compositions of the component is any ratio. The compositions of the component is in any ratio is called mixture. But compositions of the component is a fixed ratio, that is called a compound. For example, hydrogen oxygen mixture in vessels, but compound means hydrogen oxygen mixture to form water molecule. H2 mole, oxygen is 1 mole. This is 2 is to 1 ratio. It is called a fixed ratio. Then third one, it show the property of compound. Here, property of component is exhibited. Here, property of the component different from the compound. So different property then component. So hydrogen is one character, chlorine is one character. So to make HCl, compound is one character. So here this is a mixer, both are having gaseous component, exhibit same character, but HCl is a compound, so it is different from the component of the mixer. So fourth one, the component can be separated by only physical method. This is called a mixer. So all mixture of component can be easily separated from one another by using physical method, solid, liquid, liquid, gas, gas, solid, 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 etc., etc. But here the component can be separated only by chemical method. Oxidase, separation method, fractional distillation and crystallization, vaporization, sublimation. So this like separation method applied for component of substance of element or matter. So this is main difference between mixture and compound. So next we are discuss about summarizing this of lesson part. So last part of this lesson, so matter. So matter means already we know that. So all matter exhibit in three phase: solid, liquid and gaseous nature. So this matter to make two type of substance. One is called pure substance and another one is called impure substance. So in this entire world contain all the substance of the body make as a matter or particle. So this is converted into two nature depend upon their appearance at the pure and impure form. So mixture have no fixed composition, but the pure substance have fixed composition. So this is furtherly classified into two types: elements and compound. So element means cannot be broken down to the simpler substance because it is also called atom or ion. So it is a single pieces or simpler pieces, so it is not broken noble matter. So this element of matter is periodic table contain all atom is called good examples of element: copper, oxygen, iron, gold, silver, platinum, etc., etc. So this element all are include metal, non-metal, semi-metal in periodic table. So this is called element. So compound. Compound means it is have fixed composition, can be easily broken into element by chemical or electrochemical method. Chemical or electrochemical reaction method. For example, water, methane, sugar, salt, acid, base, organic and inorganic compound, all are easily broken into element by using suitable chemical method. So this is called a chemical compound. So water H2O, 2:1 fixed ratio, methane CH4, 1:4 ratio, sugar 6:12 ratio, salt 1:1 ratio. So these all are fixed ratio. So this is called pure substance of matter. So next, mixture of matter. So mixture of matter means no fixed composition. First you can understand that. So they are classified into two broad type depending upon their exhibiting composition. So homogeneous. Homogeneous means simply called exhibit the uniform composition. For example, sugar in water. Sugar molecule is a solid nature, water is a liquid nature. Both are mixed after shaken, converted into single of liquid nature. So it is undergoes boiling and then cold means it is converted into crystallization, solid nature. So moreover, two or different phase of substance converted into single uniform level means that is called homogeneous. So another one example is salt in water, sulfur in carbon disulfide, sulfur in carbon disulfide, carbon disulfide. So sulfur is easily dissolved in carbon disulfide. So water dissolved in alcohol. So these are make single liquid or solid nature. But before mixing they are exhibit different phase, but after mixing it is exhibit single phase. So this is called a homogeneous mixture of matter. Then heterogeneous mixture of matter means it is non uniform composition. Non uniform means you can easily understand. so they are exhibit different pace of matter. For example, sand in water, salt in alcohol, sugar and salt in water and oil. So these are best examples of heterogeneous mixture. So water and oil is best examples of heterogeneous. So water is a light thickness of liquid, oil is a high density of liquid. So both are do not miscible. So it is exhibit different layer in different liquid form, liquid density, different character also. So this type of mixture have not fixed composition. So this like of matter is called a heterogeneous mix. So lesson over. So now you can easily understand what is mean by homogeneous, what is mean by heterogeneous, what is mean by substance, what is mean by mixture, what is mean by element, what is mean by physical change, what is mean by chemical change. So all are understand easily with a different example. Now we are discussed here. So this lesson is over. So next, this week assignment topic, the first question, state what are element, statement of element. So in this first question have the second topic, what are the three main type of element, and the third category, property of each type element. So this is 5-mark questions. So second questions, give 2 point difference between element and compound, 2 difference point in short form, distinguish them. So next, third one assignment, is water a component, prove your answer. This is third questions. This is third questions. Then fourth one is name some homogeneous as well as heterogeneous mixture. Then fifth one, what are the difference between physical and chemical change? First difference in definition, second difference in some suitable example, third example difference is technique. So this 5 questions is your assignment topic. Thank you, students.